Hello students, let us continue with our AVS chapter. Now tell me, do you eat food?
Yes, isn't it?
Why do we eat food?
To get energy. To get energy, we eat food.
Yes, now tell me, do we eat food regularly?
Yes, we intake food regularly.
Where does it go?
You don't know about it.
It goes to the stomach. Your answer will be it goes to the stomach, right? What happens to the food in the stomach? Do you know about it? So let us study about the food digestion in our today's class. Now see this picture. This is a picture of digestion of food in human beings. So digestion of food in human beings. What happens is the food that you intake, that in the mouth we chew the food, that food items will cut into small particles. So teeth, what is the function of the teeth in the mouth is they chew the food items into small particles. Okay, they chew the food items into small particles and it goes inside through the food pipe. You see, this is the food pipe. You can see here. Till here it is a food pipe. Then in the food pipe, what happens? The chewed food reaches the stomach through the food pipe. So here you intake the food, here you chew the food, teeth will cut your food into small pieces, then it goes inside, digest it to some extent. So here the big particle food converts into small particles, right? Then in the stomach, that small particles become further small by mixing with some acids present in the stomach. So food in the stomach get digested to some extent. So up to 4 hours your food will be in the stomach. Okay, it remains here for about 3 to 4 hours. After that, then this food reaches the small intestine. It reaches the small intestine, you see here. It reaches the small intestine. Here what happens? It becomes still smaller. It becomes still smaller. Then this food reaches the small intestine and get digested further. The digested food reaches the blood. Then it get digested further. Then the digested food reaches the blood through the small intestine and reaches the all parts of the body. So here, from here it reaches the blood and it reaches all through your body. Then what about the undigested food? So digested food converts into blood. Undigested food reaches the large intestine. This is the large intestine, you see here. This is the large intestine. Okay, and moves out of the body through anus in the form of feces. Okay, from here it comes out from your body. Undigested food will come out. Okay, so this is all about the process of digestion. Let me explain it once again. So you're taking food through your mouth. In the mouth there are teeth. Teeth will chew the food and they convert into small pieces. Then the chewed food reaches the stomach through the food pipe. Food in the stomach get digested to some extent. It remains here for 3 to 4 hours. Then the food reaches the small intestine and it get digested further. The digested food reaches the blood through small intestine and reaches all the parts of the body. The undigested food reaches the large intestine and moves out of the body through anus in the form of feces. Okay, this is all about the process of digestion. Observe this picture. The food you eat moves from the organs to organs from the mouth. Look at the picture and write the names of those organs. So first one, it is mouth, right here, mouth. Then second one, from the food pipe, then it goes to the stomach, small intestine, large intestine, anus. Okay, you write it here. Have you written the names of the organs? Now write the parts of our mouth. So parts of our mouth are teeth, tongue. Yes, then which part of the mouth is helpful for chewing the food items? Teeth, tongue and saliva. Then what is the function of the tongue? To taste the food. Here you see the details of all the organs which are used for digestion are given in details. Okay, you see here the process by which the food get digested and reaches the blood is called as digestion. So if they ask what is digestion, you must write the answer. The process by which the food get digested and reaches the blood is called as digestion. Now tell me, what are the good habits that we must follow? Wash your hands before and after taking the food. Eat fibrous food such as beans, radish, etc. Eat fresh and healthy food. Clean your mouth, teeth and tongue after eating the food. Chew the food slowly and properly. It is better to eat once in 4 hours. So why once in 4 hours? Because food in the stomach will remain up to 4 hours. Okay, then it just goes to the intestine and digested food will convert into blood. Undigested food will come out of the body through the anus in the form of feces. So it's nice if you eat every 4 hours. Okay, see the next one. Write the functions of the organs given in the picture in the space provided. Already I explained to you. So first one, chew the food item, that is mouth. To chew the food item, and the food items get converted into small particles, isn't it? Then the food pipe, what happens? The chewed food reaches the stomach through the food pipe. Then the stomach, food in the stomach get digested to some extent and remains up to 4 hours. Then it is small intestine. Food from the stomach reaches the small intestine and get digested further. Then the large intestine, undigested food reaches the large intestine and comes out of the body from the anus in the form of feces. Okay, now we have learnt about this digestion. Next is we are going to study about the process of excretion. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is excretion. Now, waste is produced in your houses, like after cooking the vegetable waste or other wastes. What will you do with that waste? Yes, we throw out that waste is in the dustbin, isn't it? Yes, similarly in our body, what happens is there are many materials which are waste materials. Those materials are not required for the body, but those materials are produced in our body due to some biological processes like digestion. I told you, undigested food will come out from the body through the anus. So these waste particles, okay, these waste particles remain, if they remain in the body, they will cause some diseases. So body removes these wastes through skin and lungs. So we call these organs as excretory organs. Excretory organs are nothing but the organs which are used to remove waste from a body. These are called as excretory organs. Now you know that our body removes waste through urine, right? So let us study about excretory organs in human body. What is this picture? This is the picture of human excretory organs. So human excretory organ will contain a pair of kidneys situated either side of the backbone. So this is one and this is the two. These are the pair of kidneys situated either side of the backbone. Now, what is the function of this kidney, sir? The blood gets filtered here. The blood gets filtered here. Impurities present in the blood are separated. This waste reaches the urinary bladder. You can see here, urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder. So, all the waste materials will reach here. That is to the urinary bladder through the urinary canal. This is the canal, the pipe-like structure. This is the urinary canal. Through the urinary canal, it reaches the urinary bladder. Then it passes out of the body using urethra. So it from urethra it comes out of the body. This is the process of excretion in humans. So let me explain it once again. A pair of kidneys are situated on the either side of the backbone. The blood gets filtered here. Impurities present in the blood are separated here. This waste reaches the urinary bladder through urinary canal. Then it passes out of the body through urethra in the form of urine. Observe the above picture. Write its parts here. So first one is the kidney. Next the urinary canal. Then urinary bladder. Then urethra. So this part I have explained to you just now. That is the process of excretion. You see here. Answer the following question. Which organ is responsible for the removal of carbon dioxide from the body? Answer is lungs. Which organ removes impurities from the body in the form of sweat? That is skin. Which organ removes impurities from the body in the form of liquid? That is urethra, or you can write kidneys also. Okay. Now tell me, what are the healthy habits that you have to follow to the proper functioning of the process of excretion in human body? So first one is pass the urine regularly. Some of you, if the urine has to be passed also, control and keep it. That is the bad habit. So what you have to do is you have to pass the urine regularly. Take bath every day and wear clean clothes. Wash your face, hands and legs often. It helps to remove the waste in which are collected through sweat. This cleans the skin and opens the sweat pores. Drink 2 liters of clean water every day. It helps to remove waste from the body in the form of sweat and urine. So now tell me what you have learned in this total chapter, Our Body, A Wonderful Machine. Human body, we call it as a wonderful machine because that performs various functions like respiration, blood circulation, digestion, excretion, etc. Isn't it? So we call our body as a wonderful machine. So you have to practice some healthy habits, do some exercises, yoga, play some games, okay, eat healthy food, do not overeat fried food items and sweets. So avoid eating more of fried food items and sweets. You have to take bath every day, okay, every day take bath and keep your body clean. Wear washed clothes daily, okay. Before wearing any cloth, make sure that it is washed. There are 206 bones and more than 600 joints in a human body. Our heart beats about 70 times per minute and 1 lakh times per day. 3 liters of air is filled in the lungs. Human body contains about 5.5 liters of blood. Blood will be produced after donating the blood. it needs 4 to 5 weeks.